Hello, 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 everybody. Happy Monday. Brooke Jean here with Brooke Jean Counseling and Coaching. I am just cleaning off my LED glasses real quick because I smudged the living daylights out of them. What's up, everybody? I am hopping on today from my home office. So our family has recently moved, and this is the place that the magic happens in the home. And this morning, really early in the morning, my daughter was having a hard time sleeping last night. I knew that she was tired. I mean, scared. We were watching like Halloween stuff before bed, which, note to parents, not a good idea. I knew she was scared, and I knew it was kind of too dark in her room. And anyways, she kind of was up throughout the night. And so in the middle of the night, as I was anticipating her waking up again, because we do that as moms, we like, even if they're sleeping, we're still awake waiting for them to wake up. I was thinking about how I could start my week off, transitioning from the weekend into the work week in a more peaceful state that felt more in alignment with just who I'm trying to be these days. And I thought to myself, instead of getting up and trying to get myself and my daughter ready to take her to school, to then go to work, to then start my day, to then be in my office the whole day, then pick her up, then come home, then make dinner and do all the things, why not just don't get ready, take her to school, come home, work, see some clients, go on a run, see some more clients, do some meditating, see some more clients, then decide. Anyways, this kind of pivot that I made in my day and in the start of my week this morning inspired what I wanted to share with you today, which is, how do we leverage times of change like we are living in right now as an opportunity to pivot, as an opportunity to become? Okay, so I don't know why I hadn't thought of this simple shift in my schedule of just working from home all day on Monday so I could have a better balance and therefore, you know, be able to access all the things that help me feel my best and do my best. I realized that we're so blocked with noise and information and things coming at us and our old beliefs about ourselves and our old rules that we all live by. We get so blocked and blinded by this stuff that sometimes what's obvious in terms of where we need to pivot is not accessible. We don't see it. It's outside of our awareness. So if you've been following any of these lives, I've been talking a ton about how the pandemic, along with the racial justice movement and this election, has become a pressure cooker for change. And what I've been saying is how, when we don't really know what's gonna happen next, when we can't control the future and predict outcomes, our brain and bodies have evolved to sense that as danger and to try to quickly formulate what it thinks is gonna happen. And when it doesn't have all the information to accurately predict what's going to happen, it fills the gaps with whatever story and narrative you have about yourself and the world around you. So for example, if your story is everyone's out to get me, then right now, when we can't control the future, we can't predict the outcomes, you're probably telling yourself a story that looks a little something like, everyone's out to get me, I'm not safe, this person's mad at me, my boss hates me, and you're kind of creating those realities for yourself. Okay, so we have to know that that is happening. And PS, our nervous systems are reacting to this perceived threat. And so because we're in this collective trauma response, this collective existential crisis, this collective shift that I've been calling kind of the shift, we are not seeing clearly where it is that we need to pivot, where it is that we need to make changes to take advantage of this collective shift, to rise into who we're becoming, okay? And so I wanted to share a little tip today on, like, how do we do this? So how do I clear out all the noise so I can receive the information around where I can shift, where I can level up, what I can release that is no longer serving me. And it's all going to happen in moments of stillness. And it's going to come from your internal guide, your internal wisdom, your body, your feelings, or something bigger than you outside of you. So what I want you to do is I want you to be thinking about, where is my brain and my body kind of showing up in a survival response? And how is that distracting me from leveraging this as an opportunity to change in a positive way? So the example that I love to talk about with my clients is all of the conflict I'm watching happen on Facebook and just where social media platforms, okay? As a mental health professional, as a coach, as my partner was calling me, sorry, I just had to, bye-bye, sorry, honey. As all these things, what I see is people's inner teenagers being in a subconscious trauma response, which means they're fighting, flighting, freezing, or shut down by way of flinging their poo at each other, AKA their projections, all day long. And it is so sad because I feel like not knowing that that's what we're doing and that's what we're engaging in is preventing us from seeing what's really happening right in front of us, which is this collective shift, which becomes an opportunity. So where have you been distracted? Where have you been busy, worrying, predicting worst case scenarios, hating your neighbor, hating your friend on Facebook? Because all that is just noise that is pulling you further away from the real work that needs to happen right now, which the real work is about slowing down, listening, and raising consciousness, not only as individuals, but as a collective. Because it's from our place of consciousness that we're actually going to drive real change in the world. It's that how we're actually going to show up for each other. So slow down. Okay, take pauses throughout your day to breathe, to turn your attention inward to your body and to asking it, like, what's going on? How am I feeling? Where am I holding it in my body? What part of me is ready to change? If I were to change, who would I become? Okay. And like I've said before in previous segments, a lot of us are being kind of like railroaded. It's a nice way to put it. Railroaded by the areas of us that are ready to change, right? So I've been honest in my last blog that at the beginning of quarantine, when I started getting really uncomfortable, really anxious, started carrying, you know, my own fears, the world's fears, I started drinking too much, eating too much, spending too much, and I was getting sick every single day. And it became very clear that these self-destructive patterns that I have developed in order to cope with my own yucky feelings in the body are not working for me anymore. They're outdated, they're not in alignment with who I am today, and they're wreaking havoc. And so it became really clear to me, like, no, I don't want to eat more, drink more, and spend more as a way to cope with hard things, as a way to stuff my feelings, as a way to not feel my body. I want to have a good relationship with my body. I want to treat it like the temple that it is. And I want to start living in alignment with, like, what matters most to me. And so getting sick every day was a way that the pandemic was becoming a pressure cooker for change, and a way that I was able to see, holy shit, I've got some things that I am ready to release, because in this pivot, I'm leveling up and I'm not bringing these with me. These old chestnuts, they love to come forward in the most stressful of times, and I don't handle the stress well, and I fall back into these conundrums, and I'm done. Okay? And so people ask me every day, like, well, how do I feel better? How do I get to the bottom of this? How do I know what I need to change? Give me the order in which I do things and what I do. And the problem is there isn't a handbook for this, guys. What you need to do to shift and pivot and level up is completely unique to you. But you're not going to find that information from anything or anyone outside yourself. You already have what you need inside of you to do this work, including the answers around what you need to do and what parts of you you're ready to let go of and what parts of your being you're ready to retire. Okay? It's not about doing, it's about being different. And that's where the real work lies, my friends. People don't want to do that work. They don't want to have these really difficult conversations with themselves around, what am I doing to self-sabotage? What am I doing to get in my own way of reaching potential? Because it means they're going to have to change. Okay? Like coming home from work and going on a walk or a run and listening to my favorite podcast and then taking a bath and, you know, hanging out with my kids is different than coming home and drinking wine and numbing out and shopping on Amazon Prime. Of course, I want to go into what's comfortable and familiar, but if I want different, I have to be different, which means every step of the way, I have an opportunity to do it the old way or do it the new way. So tell me what I want to hear what you guys are hearing as I'm saying this. Hi, Katie. I want to hear what you're hearing because I feel like I'm giving you so much information and I'm usually just channeling it. So it doesn't always come out eloquently. And I'm fine with that. But I think what I really want you to hear is that there is an opportunity in this chaos. Chaos precedes change. Change is inevitable and necessary for growth. And it's those of us that can have the awareness to take advantage of this and pivot that are going to really kind of do some deep personal work and come out on the other side with some new stuff, some new exciting things to look forward to, some new ways of being that yield us different results and different outcomes. Okay. So if there's one thing that you take away, it's slow down and listen to your own internal guidance system. We've been conditioned to ignore our bodies, to hate our bodies, to self-destruct our bodies, to stuff our feelings, to eat our feelings, to drink our, right? Like, you guys hear me, the list goes on and on. And so when I ask you to stop and listen to your body, I realize that it's counterproductive, counterintuitive. I tried to combine those two there. But that's okay that it feels that way because it's different, but it's exactly the place that we need to be. So the answers to your questions are not on Facebook. They're not, outside yourself. They're inside. And so slow down, ask yourself these questions, check in with your body and let your body be your guide and let your feelings kind of lead you to where you need to go. So how are you pivoting in this collective pressure cooker, right? When I think of a pressure cooker, I'm like, no steam can get out. And eventually it's just, boo, here's your problem. Here's how you're going to solve it. So I would love to hear what's emerging for you guys. I would love to hear what questions you have about this kind of concept that I'm sharing, whether it's in relation to the brain and body's response to this sort of collective experience we're in, how that's noise and a distraction to the real work that we could be doing, and how to do the real work. I'm gonna continue to share tips throughout this whole, probably forever in my career, on how to navigate transition and navigate change in a healthy way and in a way that gets you closer to being the truest you you've ever been, the youest you you've ever been. And so I think today's tip, if I have to summarize all 9 of those points, is what are you willing to let go of in order to step into who you could become? And what parts of you are showing up during this kind of collective crisis that you're like, oh, that doesn't feel good anymore. I'm not proud of that. I don't like that. That's not yielding me a positive result. That's not getting me closer to feeling my best or being my best or having the life I want. Slow down and think on that and feel on that and see what else is there, because my guess is that's exactly the work that you're ready to do. So I hope this message finds you well enough. I know that it's not great right now. But I do. I feel kind of in my heart and soul that there's an opportunity to pivot here. And I don't know. Let's do our work. Take care of yourselves and each other. Let me know if you need anything. You know where to find me, and I will talk to you all soon. Bye.